In the Tyranid army, the big creatures are real centerpieces, and the Maliceptor, with its really creepy, horrible brain and massive claws, is no exception. Now, in this video, I'm going to show you how to paint one in the colour scheme of High Fleet Leviathan, and as you're going to see, painting a big Tyranid creature is actually no different from painting a small Tyranid creature. So no matter what you're doing for your army, you're going to find something useful in this video. Let's get started. One of the best ways I find of painting miniatures is to start with the largest area of colour, and in this case it's going to be the monster's skin. Now this is especially true when you're painting Tyranids. I really recommend you do it this way around. That's because it's much easier to neaten up the other areas like the carapace than it is to neaten up the skin once you've finished it. So for this model we're going to be doing High Fleet Leviathan, and you'll notice we've undercoated it black, and you might be wondering why, seeing as Leviathan's got quite a pale colour scheme to it. That's because I find that Chaos Black really lends itself to the shading on deeper areas in the miniature, and the skin's got quite a lot of this. And also because there's other areas of colour on the model that work much better from a black undercoat, and again the carapace is a great example of this. So the first colour that you need is Rakarth Flesh, and as always give your paints a good shake when you're using each one. And the brush I'm going to be applying this with is my large dry brush, and that's because this monster's so large. If you're doing a smaller Tyranid, things like a Gaunt, then you want to switch to a smaller brush. A large brush is good for something like that. So what you need to do is just load up some paint in your brush and then put it onto a palette. And having a palette's really useful in this stage, and it's because it allows me to control how much paint I got on the brush. You don't want to be applying too much at once, you see, because if you do, you can lose control of it and start clogging at the detail. If you apply it thinner, then you'll get a much better result in the end. So once you're ready, all you got to do is start applying this to your model on all the areas that you want to be the skin colour. And you can be quite rough at this stage because all these other areas are going to be neatening up by painting later on anyway. Make sure you really work it into all those nooks and crannies, because there are quite a lot in this model. And well, you'll still be able to see some of the black undercoat through at some stages, at some parts, especially around the tail here. That's absolutely fine. As I say, applying thin coats is better because I can let this dry and apply another one later on and get a solid colour. It's always best to apply multiple thin coats rather than one thick coat. Well, whilst you're doing this stage, remember to do these parts around the brain here. If your model's got a brain, make sure you've base coat these bits too. And there we go, I've just finished doing the second coat, and you can see because of that I've got a really solid colour here. And well, also I just want to quickly point out that on the carapace you get these weird little kind of vent things really, so make sure you base coat those at the same time because they're going to be a fleshy colour in the end. And also, you notice I've painted his tongue with a base colour too. So once you finish that stage, the next step is to move on to a layer paint, and I'm going to be using Screaming Skull for this. I'm going to be applying it in the same kind of way. Now you might be wondering why then we bothered putting Rakarth Flesh down first of all, and that's because Screaming Skull is a layer paint and quite a thin one, so think of it as being kind of transparent. Having the Rakarth Flesh down first means this colour is going to be much stronger when we're finished with it than it would be if you just painted it straight over the black undercoat. So the brush I'm using is again my large dry brush, and well, as I say, I'm just going to be applying this in the same kind of way. So get some loaded on your brush, not too much once again, and you just need to paint this all over the skin areas that you've just done, and the brain and the tongue and those little vents too, making sure you really work it into the nooks and crannies. Now, as I say again, this is going to be quite a transparent colour, so you probably will need to apply two coats of it. Remember, thin coats are always better though. Resist the temptation to do one thick coat. It's taken me two coats of Screaming Skull to get to this point, but you can see now we've got a really good strong cream colour for all the flesh, which is perfect for the next stage, which is to apply a shade to it. Now the colour I'm going to use for this is Caraberg Crimson, but I'm not going to apply it all over the flesh because that'll turn the model pink and I want to keep it this kind of cream colour. So instead I'm going to be much more focused about how I apply it. So I've got a fine detail brush and a standard brush for that purpose, and when you get your paint ready, this is the fine detail brush I'm using for this first part, just make sure you don't have too much paint on your brush because you need to keep a control of where you're applying this. So what you're looking to do on the flesh is to paint this into all the deepest recesses. So for example, on the leg round here, I'm going to be painting it into this join running along there between the skin and the carapace, so just letting the shade settle in that recess down there. And then I've got all these little recesses around the knee here, so you're just going to be painting it into the parts like this. Now there are some parts where you need to apply this shade all over, and these parts are scattered across the model, so I'll show you what I mean with these. I've got these little kind of almost like vent-like things I'm going to be painting all over those parts, and the same is true on the brain, on the tongue, and also on all the joints in the limbs, like this one just down here. Now, as you're doing this, it's possible that you will get some of this shade in areas where you don't want it, but don't worry about that because we're going to be neatening up afterwards. And, well, that's especially true in areas where you're going to be applying quite a lot of this shade. So I'll give you an example of one of those now. I'm going to be putting quite a lot in these recesses in the ribs, and I've got, well, a full load on the brush here. You just need to poke it into those parts to get it into that recess like that. Now that shade is dry, you can see what a massive difference it's made to the model. It's really defined all the detail on the skin. And now that's done, the next stage is to, well, to neaten it up really, because it's inevitable when you're doing that style of shading that you will get some smudges on the miniature. So for this, we're going to go back to Screaming Skull, and I'm going to be applying it using a standard brush this time. Now, when you get the paint ready on your palette, this time just add a little bit of water to it, not very much, just to thin it down. This will help the paint flow smoother onto the model. And also, just twist your brush on the palette once you've got enough paint on there. Just twist your brush on the palette as you drag it along. This will bring the bristles to a nice tip, which will give you lots of control over what you need to do. Because now, really, you just need to look around your miniature to try and find any little smudges or mistakes. So I've got some around the tail just here. All you've got to do is paint Screaming Skull over these parts. Now, like earlier when we were doing it, you might need to apply more than one coat to get a smooth coverage, but really it's just a matter of taking your time and getting all these areas. So that little smudge there. And once you've done this around all the skin, well, we're nearly done with the flesh, really. There's only one more step on it. But just so you're aware, you don't need to do this on the areas for the carapace because we're going to be painting them later anyway. Now we've finished neatening up, you can see we've got that pinkish tinge to what is otherwise just really pale skin. And now that that's done, there's just one more step on the flesh to do, and that's to add a highlight. Now for this, the colour you need is Pallid Witch Flesh. I'm going to be applying it using my fine detail brush because, well, this is the neatest part of doing all the skin. So like when we were neatening up earlier on, you just need to put your paint on your palette, thin it with a little bit of water, then use your palette to make sure you've got a good tip on your brush, not too much paint there. And what you're looking to do with this is to paint lines running along all the ridges in the skin. So if I go back to this leg again, show you what I mean around here. If you look at this kind of bone structure we've got appearing underneath the skin here, it sort of creates lines where the corners are. So you just need to paint some of this just running along those lines like that. Now doing this highlight really defines all this detail. So you'll clearly see all these features now standing out in a distance, like on a game or in a cabinet or wherever. But just take your time with this stage because it really does make the difference here. And you'll need to also paint these lines running around these kind of like these gaps in the skin here. So just be as neat as you can around those parts. And with that highlight done, the skin is now complete and we can move on to the next largest area in the miniature to paint, which is the carapace, and well, the purple carapace. Now for this, the first colour you need is Nagaroth Knight, and because it's so large on this miniature, I'm going to be mostly using my large brush, but I've also got a standard brush for the smaller areas that are a bit trickier to get to. Now for this step, you're looking to get, well, once again, as even a colour as you can. So I'm going to be thinning my paint with a little bit of water, not too much. This is just to help it dry smoothly on the miniature and make sure I don't have too much on the brush. I've watered it down a little bit too much there. A bit more paint. There we go, that's better. That's more what you want. Okay, so make sure you don't have too much on your brush. And, well, I'm looking to apply this onto all these carapace parts. So I'm going to go back to the leg. Once again, I'm going to paint this on here. Now, when you're doing this stage, you must be as careful as possible when you're getting around the areas where the carapace meets the skin. So just be as neat as you can around those parts. And also, there are quite a lot of carapace bits on this model that you might not actually expect to be purple. So I recommend you just use your box as a bit of guidance through this part as to which bits to paint like this. So really take your time with this part, and well, you'll notice, especially when I'm painting down here, that you can still see some of that cream colour through the purple. That's not a problem, just let this coat dry, then apply a second one afterwards. Remember, it's always best to do multiple thin coats. You'll get a much better result in the end if you do. Now that the carapace is base coated, the model's really coming on. The next stage is to apply a shade to that carapace, and well, for this the colour you need is Norma Oil, and this I'm going to apply using the same two brushes again. And again, this is so I can just jump between them as I need to, depending on what size area I'm painting. Now, when you're doing this stage, the most important thing is to make sure that you don't put on too much shade at once. That's because you need to keep in control of it so it doesn't run onto the other areas that you painted. So, using my large brush now, making sure I don't have too much on there. And what I'm going to do with this is just paint it all over these carapace parts. So if I just start up here near the brain, I'm just going to paint this all over these bits here to darken that purple down. Now, as I say, you just need to be careful when you're going around these other colours, like the brain and the skin, so that it doesn't run onto them. But there are some parts that are quite small on here, like these little vent things. And when you're going around here, it is likely that some of that shade will run over them. Now, if it does, it's not a problem. Just dry your brush quickly and use it like a sponge to absorb that shade away. But if it does dry in there, well, you don't need to worry about it. Just let it fully dry, then go over it with Screaming Skull and a little bit of Caraba Crimson to get back to that kind of pinkish colour. Now, also, when you're doing this, it's a good idea to do an entire panel of the carapace at once. That's because if you do part of it, let it dry, and then come back to it later, you can get a kind of line forming where the shade dried. So if you do it in one go, you avoid that happening. Give the Norn Oil about half an hour to dry, and once it's completely dry, you're ready for the next stage, which is to add a highlight to the carapace. Now, the colour for this is Zarius Purple. I'm going to apply it using my fine detail brush. So when you get this on your palette, you need to make sure it's thinned with water to help it flow easy, and also to make sure you don't have too much on your brush. So make sure it's on the sides of the bristles like that. And what you're looking to do is to paint this as a thin line running around the edge of all the carapace parts. So if I go around the head here, because these parts are quite pronounced, you can actually use a side of your brush and just run it along these panels like that. And this gives you a very neat straight line running all the way around the panels. So what you need to do is go around all of them doing this. Really take your time with it because it gives a nice effect once you're done. But also, we need to do that kind of like those lines that run along these parts too. Now, for this, just water down your paint a little bit more than normal, not very much more, just to help it flow smoothly. And then use your palette to get a nice fine tip in your brush, just twisting it along like that. And what you do is just start flicking your brush along that edge like that, just working away across it very lightly, and you'll see the effects start to build up. Now, how much of this you apply really is up to you, so just take your time and keep building up gradually. If you need a bit of guidance as to where exactly to do it, then just check out the box art and that'll show you. I've finished that first highlight now, and you can see it's had a nice effect on all that carapace, but it is quite subtle. So what I'm going to do now is add a second highlight, and this one's going to be Jean Stealer Purple, and this one's going to brighten it up just a bit more. So I'm still using the fine detail brush for this, and the application is going to be, well, much the same as the one we just done. So thin the paint down again and make sure there's not too much on your brush. And what I'm going to do here is focus this a bit more on kind of the corners of the carapace. So what I mean by that is if I go down this one down the side of his head, I'm going to be looking at where it arcs round, just round here, and just apply it in the same kind of way, but just on that part there. So I'm going to continue this, working all the way down around these parts here, and then also just over that crest as it goes over the top of his head there. And then when you're doing the lines that go down the carapace, I'm not going to put on quite so many, just a few, just to build up the colour a little bit more and make it just a little bit brighter. And with that last highlight done, the carapace is now complete. As you can see, we've actually painted most of the miniature now, and we're ready to move on to some of the details. Now, the first of these details I'm going to do is the claws and the hooves, and these are red. The first colour you need for this is corn red, and I'm going to be applying this colour using my large brush, my standard brush, again, so I can switch between them as I need to. So for this first step, you're just looking to get as even a base coat of this colour as you can. So let's get the paint ready on my palette, onto my brush, and well, I'm going to start out by painting this side on the front here. I'm just going to be painting this on as neatly as possible down here, just being careful around all those other colours. Once you finish the base coat of the red, the next stage is to apply a shade over it. And for this, I'm going to be, well, again, using Norn oil, and this is going to be like when we're applying it over the carapace. I'm going to be looking for a smooth coat of it all over these parts. So I've got my large brush and standard brush still, and you just need to make sure you don't have too much so that you're not applying too much at once. Because, well, I'll go back to my scythe here. I'm going to be applying this all the way down these red parts, so all over them. But just make sure that you don't put on too much so that you don't lose control of it onto the flesh or anything else. And also make sure it doesn't start like going as blobs towards the bottom of it. Just keep an eye on it to make sure it stays smooth. Now that shade is fully dry, we're ready to add a highlight to the red parts. Now for this, the first colour is going to be Evil Sun Scarlet, and I'm going to be applying this using my fine detail brush because, well, the method for this is just like when we were doing the carapace earlier. It's going to be an edge highlight following all the areas of the claws, the hooves, and all those parts. So just make sure you've got the good tip in your brush and it's thinned down the bitter water. Not too much in your brush. And what I'm going to be doing on all the sharper areas, like on the claws here, I'm just going to be using the side of my brush and just running it along these edges here to get a nice, neat, straight line running all the way down them like that. Now, on some of these parts, there aren't obvious lines to do this on, for example, the claws here. And in this case, you just need to paint a straight line just running down toward the tips, just like that. And you'll see this effect on the box artwork as well. And there we go, that's the highlight done. Now, you could, of course, leave it here, and on a smaller creature like a termagant, that's exactly what I'd do. But on larger tyrannid creatures, it's often nice just to add an extra highlight, and this has the effect of making the claws appear sharper. Because they're so much bigger, it really adds a bit more interest to them. Now, if you want to do this, the colour you need is Wild Rider Red, and I'm going to be applying this once again with my fine detail brush, because, well, the application is much the same as what we've just done. Make sure you thin your paint down, and you don't have too much on your brush. But this time, I'm going to be much more focused about where I apply it. So if I start again on these big sides in the front here, these big claws here, all I'm going to do is just paint a bit of this just towards the tip. So just down there like that. And you see this has the effect of making the claw appear that much sharper towards the tip. And with that last highlight of Wild Rider Red, all the claws are finished. And well, there's not that much more left to do. Just a couple of details to finish the model off. Now, the first of these I'm going to do is the brain and the tongue. And for this, you're going to need three different colours. I'm going to start out with a shade of Caraberg Crimson. Then I'm going to layer using Emperor's Children. And then finally add a highlight using a Shabti Bone. So to start out with a Caraberg Crimson, I'm going to apply this using my large brush. And well, we've already done one coat of this much earlier on, remember when we were painting the skin. So this is going to be the second coat of it. And this is ready to set up for later because applying this is going to make the brain much redder than what it is right now. So you see, I'm just going to paint this straight over the top like that, letting it settle in the recesses, and you can see it's much redder, which is perfect for the next stage. When the shade's fully dry, use your standard brush to apply some Emperor's Children onto the brain. Now I'm going to be focusing on the raised areas here, leaving that shade showing in the darker areas like that around there. Now you also need to do the same thing on the tongue. And well, there aren't that many recesses on the tongue, so you will find you'll be painting most of it. But like I say, you just need to follow it round, leaving all those deeper areas with a darker colour showing. The final step of this part is to use your fine detail brush to add a highlight of a Shabti Bone. So for this, what you want to do is just paint a little bit along the sort of the top of the curve of these tubes. So all along areas like that there. Also, you need to do the veins that go down across it, so just these little bits, just pick them out like that. And finally, for the tongue, I'm just looking for, well, the edge really, that goes down here around this little sort of spike at the end of it. So just a little bit of a Shabti Bone just along there, like that. And with that highlight done, the brains and the tongue are now finished. And well, there's only one more detail left to do, and that is the teeth. Now for doing this, you're going to need three colours. We'll start with a base coat of Rakarth Flesh, then shade over them with Agrax Earthshade, and finally add a highlight using Pallid Witch Flesh. And for all these stages, I'm going to be using a fine detail brush because the teeth are quite small. So starting out with the Rakarth Flesh, for this first step, just make sure that you don't have too much of your paint on the brush so that you can keep them under control. And well, you're just looking to do a base coat as neatly as you can. So you just need to be very neat so that you don't get this colour on the tongue, like that. With the base coat done, apply Agrax Earthshade all over the teeth. And as you're doing this, remember, just be careful that you don't get this on the jaw or the tongue. And then to finish the teeth off, just get a little bit of Pallid Witch Flesh and just paint a small amount of it down the middle of each tooth, just like that. And well, once you've done this, all you've got to do is base your miniature, and then you're finished. So there we go, the Maliceptor's now complete, and well, I'm really happy with how it's come out. Remember, everything I've shown you in this video will be useful to you no matter what tyranny creature you're painting, whether it's something really big like the Maliceptor, or even the smallest Ripper Swarm. So remember, when you're painting Tyranids, a really great way to do them is to start out by painting the flesh. That's because it covers so much of a large area on the miniature, and if you do it first, well, you can be quite messy with it, and then neaten up as you go along. Also, when you're painting, you can find sometimes the paints will be a bit transparent and you can see other colours through them. This is absolutely fine. When it does happen, just resist the temptation to apply a thick coat of paint. Keep those coats thin and build it up, because if you do, you'll stay in control of the paint and you'll get a smoother finish and also avoid clogging any detail. And finally, neatness really is the key. I know it's a bit of a mantra for me at this point, but well, the neater you are, the better the final result's going to be, especially when you're using shades towards the end of painting a miniature. It's easy to lose control of them and get them on areas where you don't want them. Now, I hope you found something useful in this video because, well, we've really enjoyed making it. I'll see you next time. Have fun painting your Tyranids.